Now we're going to go over a triangle from the closed guard. First step with the triangle is hand control. I need to grab the back of Ray's neck, and I need to place my hand at the inside of Ray's elbow. Secondly, what I'm going to do is scoop my hips out. If I need to, I can use this foot, scoop my hip out, slide my hand down to the wrist, and extend. Third step is going to be to bring my leg through his arm, up over his neck, and I'm going to grab my shin as well, pulling my elbow to my own hip. And then fourth step, I'm going to scoop my hips to the side, bring my leg over my other ankle, and squeeze, grabbing the back of Ray's head, and forcing the tap out. The first key point to getting the triangle is going to be head control. So with my left hand, I want to make sure I hang on Ray's head, because if Ray postures up, I can control him here and bring my hips up to follow his head. If I don't have his head with my hand right here, as Ray postures up, I'm not going to be able to get my hips up high enough. And even if I can get my hips up high enough, Ray can stand up out of my triangle. But again, if I have head control right here, as soon as Ray postures up, I can hold on to it and bring my triangle up to Ray. The second point is to make sure I grab my shin here. And I want to grab it just above my ankle. And as I grab my shin, I want to pull it in as tight as I can to my body. And I'm going to bring my elbow as tight to my hip as I can. This way, if Ray starts moving, trying to get out of the triangle, I can keep this pressure before I actually lock it up. So remember to grab the back of the head and grab your shin, pulling it down.